Hi folks, Will from MinIO here, and in this module, we're going to introduce you to MinIO AIStor. Over the course of the next couple of videos, we're going to cover what is MinIO AIStor, as well as AIStor features. And last, we're going to do a little demonstration of deploying AIStor itself. At the end of this module, you will be able to describe the features of MinIO AIStor and why you might want to use it in your own environment, deploying AIStor with Kubernetes, and also adding an AIStor site to an existing AIStor deployment. And you'll also be able to deploy an object store. So let's go ahead and answer the question, what is MinIO AIStor? MinIO AIStor is a unified management interface for enterprise features. This includes object store, which is MinIO itself, but also catalog, load balancer, observability, and key management. AIStor is designed to run on top of Kubernetes. What this means to you is that if you are running Kubernetes in any of these various flavors that you see here, Red Hat OpenShift or Amazon Elastic Kubernetes Service, you can deploy AIStor very simply. There are many different Kubernetes providers available. Most of them will work with AIStor. And AIStor is an enterprise-supported platform, which means that we will be there to give you help. Let's talk a little bit about some of the features of AIStor that you might want to use in your environment. First off is the AIStor console. Now, this is the centerpiece of what we're going to be showing you here in this module. It's a single pane of glass to see and manage all of your MinIO deployments and all of the additional features. It also acts as the launch point for the complete suite of all the AIStor features, which we're going to be talking about a little more. And it's the main point of entry into AIStor itself. So when you first log into AIStor, what you're going to see is that console interface. The object store is a managed deployment of MinIO. It performs all the standard functions of a MinIO object store. Object stores can also be managed via the command line MC client, but the purpose of the console is to allow you to have this global management of all of your object stores that you deploy. The AIStor catalog gives us this nice graphical API for querying objects and buckets across all of our deployments. It uses GraphQL to support robust queries. The GraphQL example that you see here on the screen is going to be querying for a demo bucket, and it's going to return back the bucket, the key, and any user metadata about any objects that it finds. This is going to allow you to very easily find any object that you've uploaded anywhere in your deployment. AIStor Observability is a monitoring dashboard for object stores. It gives you access to metrics, logs, and system data, and also gives you access to built-in troubleshooting tools, the same sort of troubleshooting tools that MinIO engineers use directly to help our enterprise customers. The AIStor Load Balancer is a data-centric object storage firewall. It's designed to be very lightweight, so you can run it alongside your AIStor service very easily. The Load Balancer gives you very fine-grained rules that you can set on buckets, prefixes, and objects to throttle access and also to limit access. And the last feature I wanted to mention here is the AIStor Key Management Server. This is a highly available KMS supporting per-object encryption. It's designed to scale up to the billions of cryptographic operations that are required when you're going to be encrypting every single object that you send to your object store. This also has multi-tenancy with individual enclaves for key isolation. So if I have multiple deployments of my object store, they do not have to share keys. All the features I've mentioned here will have a more detailed deep dive in future modules. But for now, we're going to go ahead and break here. In our last video, I'm going to show you a demonstration of standing up AIStor. If you'd like to reach out with us, you can connect with us on Slack at slack.min.io, or you can just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.